For the last 60 hours, he's remained silent, only letting his lawyers do the talking. Dayanidhi Maran has tried every trick in the book to get the media focus away from him, from intimidation to slapping legal notices. But as the media exposes one questionable deal after another and asks more and more specific questions about what had happened in the Aircel Maxis deal and the investments that his brother's company received after that during Mr. Maran's tenure as telecom minister, many questions are now still unanswered. The union minister, perhaps realizing that he stands totally isolated, was forced to break his silence, claiming, like many others before him, that he was in the political wilderness when the controversial Maxis deal took place. Unfortunately for him, not many are buying his straightforward defense.
This is, I've already stated, I do understand these are incidents which happened 4, 5 to 6 years back. I have also had to recall from my memory, and I'm very clear. The person who accused me in this paper today morning, the same publication published this article in 2009. And once again, this person is defending it. I'm saying, when you are an investigative journalist, why can't you go to BSNL and ask the general manager or the chief general manager who gave this letter stating that Mr. Maran had only one connection and his calls never exceed the prescribed amount which he is eligible as a member of parliament? Why can't you do that? But no. Today, I have to be hanged before you've been tried. If I have done wrong, I'm ready to face any punishment. I don't need any sympathies and I should be judged by the law. But if I'm innocent, I should be given every right to protect myself and to prove my integrity.
The union telecom minister facing growing pressure and now hitting back once more. First, he sent a legal notice to a news magazine that printed a report on decisions of Dayanidhi Maran as telecom minister. And now, a second legal notice to a national daily that has reported misuse of office to benefit Maran's brother's company. Maran has announced a quiet war against those reporting issues that raise questions on his tenure as a telecom minister. But like Tehelka, the New Indian Express is also standing by the news report.
The story was written by Mr. Guru Murthy on the basis of a letter which a special director of CBI wrote in 2007. There is no defamation. We are just quoting a document which is part of the records of the Government of India.
But Maran may find it much more difficult to take such an action against the CBI. Sources in CBI say that they may register two separate cases against Maran on the BSNL connection and the Aircel Maxis deal.
I'm accused of helping. I've never helped anyone. If someone invested in my brother's company when I was in political wilderness, when someone is, as per the thing, CBI is doing an inquiry on me for a so-called allegation. Look at who will want to do it, until another genuine person wants to invest in a person. And I have no share, I have not benefited anyone, not done anything wrong. I tell it myself.
Maran denying the allegations made against him, breaking his silence as the pressure grows.
But if I'm innocent, I should be given every right.
Bureau Report, Times Now.